My greetings to all the attendees of the conference. I am Aprajita Srivastav and I teach biology at Sunbeam School, Lehertara, Varanasi. My research is based to determine the role of diagnostic assessments in bridging the learning gaps in online teaching module. In such kind of assessments, the basic idea is to identify and recognize the targeted learning outcomes which have been achieved or which have not been achieved. Since last year, we all are facing the era of pandemic. This pandemic, which has struck us, has challenged all the educators to find out and gauge that whether our students or learners are achieving the learning outcomes which we are targeting or not. As everyone, I have also faced the same challenge. I was not able to find out that whether my students are able to absorb and assimilate the content which I am delivering in the class. So this year, I have started using a form of assessment known as diagnostic assessment, which are short scale assessments and used in classes as frequently as possible. These kind of assessments, which I have prepared in the form of Google Forms, consist of objective type questions. For example, multiple choice questions, true and false questions, match the columns, and many more. These assessments were conducted in my classes twice within a period of 40 minutes of the class. In the first 5 to 10 minutes, a pre-assessment form was given. Whereas at the end of the 40 minutes class, that is in the last 5 to 10 minutes, again a post-assessment form was given to the students, which I termed as exit tickets. The analysis of the data obtained after solving these two forms gave the students as well as me a very clear idea of achievement of targeted learning outcomes. It clearly indicated what is going well in my class and what is not going well in my class, so that I could plan my next lesson for the next week with proper reinforcement and remediation. My research included two set of experiments which were conducted with the same set of group of students. In the first experimental setup, I had taken a target group of students whose number was 20. They were from grade 10. The subject was biology and the topic was transportation in humans. For this group, I have given pre-assessment a Google form, and then after explanation of the topic, I have given them in the end an exit ticket or post-assessment. This I continued for a period of 1 week. At the end of the week, I issued them another Google form with formative assessment. With the same set of students, I conducted the second set of experiment. But here, I did not give them any diagnostic assessment form, neither the pre nor the post. This procedure was also continued for a week, and then at the end, again a formative assessment form was given. After getting the data of both the formative assessments, the data was analyzed and I could clearly see a difference in the terms of point values. With the experimental group 1, I could see that the average point obtained was 13.6 out of 15, whereas in the experiment 2, it declined to 13 out of 15. Talking about the point range, for the experiment group 1, it started from 9 to 15, whereas it declined in experiment 2 to 8 to 15. This difference in the values clearly indicated the role of diagnostic assessments in my class. When I analyzed the results, I could conclude very, very clearly that diagnostic assessments not only gave a fair idea of the learning level of the students to the teacher, but also to the students. So I insist that it is very important that the analysis of these assessments should be done with the students and doing it in synchronous class, that is the live class, so that they can also find out that what is going on well with them and where they need help. To conclude, I would suggest and I would enforce the role of diagnostic assessments as frequently as possible in the classes, because then only we can emphasize the importance of our lesson plan with remediation and reinforcement. So my research clearly advocates the role of diagnostic assessments in all synchronous classes. Also, I suggest that these diagnostic assessments forms can also be shared with the students in asynchronous way, wherein the results can be discussed, the data can be analyzed in the live class. So this was my basis of research, and I continue to do it yet, and I'll do it so that I get a better targeted learning outcome in my class. Thank you so much.